Over the past year or two, you've probably heard about speakers on various campuses being protested or shut down. The most high-profile cases have tended to happen around alt-right figures like Milo Yiannopoulos and Ann Coulter. However, it has happened at numerous universities against numerous speakers, and it's often referred to as no platforming, or trying to eliminate the university as a platform for these speakers to present their ideas. And while these protests have been common, there has also been a lot of pushback against them from both inside and outside of the university sphere. So let's take a look at a few of the pros and cons of this no platforming tactic. So the biggest pro and the main reason for no platforming is that it helps avoid normalizing and legitimizing dangerous ideas and speakers. Especially when you look at people like Richard Spencer, who are talking about creating a white ethno state and the inherent superiority of white people. These ideas are well beyond the pale of normal discussion and are very dangerous. And giving someone like that the free space and time to talk to young, impressionable students on a college campus seems very normalizing and potentially dangerous. And these protests, even if they're unsuccessful in actually stopping the event, demonstrate the unacceptability of the speaker and his ideas, and are an expression of the student's speech. Looking at the cons, one of the biggest ones is that it's highly ineffective. Many of the speakers who have been protested or have had their events otherwise disrupted have not successfully been shut down, or even if they were, they ended up getting a bigger media platform and being shown in a more favorable light because of the protests. I mean, look at Milo Yiannopoulos and the protests that happened to him at Berkeley. Yes, they may have stopped him from speaking to anyone there, but they grew his national profile enormously, and ironically helped legitimize his ideas among the far right. Another big problem is that no platforming has often had a hard time drawing the right line. While there may be speakers out there whose ideas are so offensive and so far beyond the pale and so dangerous that they are worth protesting, there are plenty of other speakers whose ideas do not go nearly that far and who are legitimately trying to have a real discussion, who have been protested, people like Professor Jordan Peterson, who, while he does have some pretty controversial views, and you can certainly disagree with the way he's gone about things, is not the same as a neo-Nazi. My take on this is that, on the whole, no platforming is not an effective tool, and that instead, when we bring controversial speakers to college campuses, we should try and pair them with someone from the opposing viewpoint and make more debates and discussions out of these rather than just large protests in which no one can actually speak. But that's just my take. Let me know what you think about the pros and cons of no platforming, and like and subscribe to learn more.